wrestling's ultimate challenge. Teams of wrestling's best athletes battle each other in hopes of winning the sport's newest treasure. But they must first conquer its most unique matches. The American Wrestling Association presents All-Star Wrestling and the Team Challenge Series. Yukon John has had plenty of practice in the lumber camps. Colonel DeBeers has fought many battles underhanded. Today, they'll face each other in a one-armed bandit match. Both wrestlers will have one arm tied behind their back. Now, let's go into the announce booth with Ralph Strangis and Greg Gagne.
Thank you, Lee Marshall, and welcome to another high-octane edition of All-Star Wrestling. I'm ringside Ralph Strangis, and this is Greg Gagne. You're still here.
Thank you. I'm still here. Still Greg Gagne.
And well, we're going to strap you in now, because what's coming up is the jetway of professional wrestling. Larry, the Living Legend, Zbyszko is going to be here today. Also, Paul Hard Rock Diamond and the Trooper. You'll see them. And the one-arm bandit match featuring Colonel DeBeers and Yukon John Nord.
Boy, you've thrown fuel on the fire, Ralph. You've got me fired up. And I know the fans are fired up because they all called and they voted. They want Paul Hard Rock Diamond and the Trooper to meet the Destruction Crew. We're going to have that match in 2 weeks.
Wow.
Also, if you want to find out who the favorite wrestler of 1989 was, call the phone line now and find out who the winner was.
And let's not delay any longer. Let's light this candle, if you will, and go straight to the ring for the Destruction Crew.
The following tag team event is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Springfield, Illinois, here is Kent Carlson. His tag team partner hails from the Sturgis Bay, Wisconsin. He is Tom Beck. Their opponents entering the ring area are the AWA World Tag Team Champions. From Chicago, Illinois, at a combined weight of 124 pounds, here are Reign Martinez and Wayne.
Destruction Crew, the AWA Tag Team Champions, led out by Wayne the Train Bloom, Mean Mike Enos, the orange construction gear and the sledgehammers. They're going to punch the clock and go to work against Kent Carlson and Tom Bennett.
Well, they are really, they're still stinging from that football match a few weeks back here in the Team Challenge Series between Mean Mike Enos and the Trooper. And the fans, you've demanded. You want to see the Destruction Crew put their title on the line against Paul Hard Rock Diamond and the Trooper. The votes are in, and we're going to have that match for you in a couple weeks right here on the AWA.
And today, our main event for the Team Challenge Series coming up a little bit later on is that one-arm bandit match featuring Yukon John Nord and,
from South Africa, your favorite, Colonel DeBeers.
Fans really getting on Enos already before they even get into the ring and go to work. Very vocal crowd today. There was a, hi, how are you, Mr. Enos?
They're number one. They're the tag team champions of the world. Me, Mike Enos, is going to start out the match with Kent Carlson.
There's Carlson waiting. And you can hear them yelling still. They're distracted by what's going on in the crowd. Very vocal crowd again, Greg, here at ringside. Enos looking like he wants to get out there and take some of them on.
Well, wherever we've been in the past few weeks, the AWA and the Team Challenge Series is on fire in front of capacity crowds all over the country. The AWA comes in your area, don't miss it.
There's Enos inside. And thrown around and waiting. For Kent Carlson was Mike Enos.
Yeah.
You heard the cackling of Wayne Bloom in the background. Oh, power slam by Enos.
You know, I made my living in professional wrestling for many years as a tag team wrestler. And I've seen all the greats, from Nick Bockwinkel and Ray Stevens, Pat Patterson and Ray Stevens, Mad Dog Vachon and Butcher Vachon, Baron Von Raschke and Horst Hoffman. And I've got to put these two young men, the Destruction Crew, give them a couple more years, and you're going to rank them right up in the Hall of Fame.
Wayne Bloom off the second rope. They've got a wrestler elevated. Now, there's a new rule as Bloom delivers it in. for the 90s, Joe Blanchard has handed down that the wrecking ball move by the Destruction Crew is no longer legal and grounds for disqualification. That is, you cannot come off the top rope when a wrestler is elevated or in the prone position.
Well, as a result of that, or the reason for it is because Enos and Bloom have hurt so many people. We've had three wrestlers from that move put in the hospital. One of them we thought was going to end up in the wheelchair for the rest of his life.
Bloom now twisting Bennett the way he wants him. And that AWA fan line, you know, has also created some real enthusiasm in the corner of Paul Diamond and the Trooper. You remember what happened the last time that they took on the Destruction Crew.
Well, in 2 weeks right here, that team challenge match, you voted for it, fans. The Destruction Crew to meet Paul Hard Rock Diamond and the Trooper.
Oh, a match that we're all looking forward to. Right now.
Oh, a back suplex off the top rope.
And Bennett just looking forward to getting out of here alive.
The Destruction Crew, every time you think that they can't come up with a new move, they come up with something new that you've never seen before. Now here they go.
Here's Wayne Bloom. He can't come off the top rope, though. Setting up the wrecking ball. Darusha looking the other way. But he saw it. You can't do that. And Darusha, I think, will have to disqualify this match.
He was almost distracted by Kent Carlson coming into the ring. And I think the Destruction Crew thought they could get away with coming off the top rope.
Look. You saw it.
There's Carlson and
Tom Bennett. The winners, of course, the belts stay in the possession of the Destruction Crew, but by disqualification, one of the new rule changes from Joe Blanchard for the 90s.
Well, I'm glad to see it. I'm glad Joe Blanchard is really cracking down on that, because as I said, there were too many wrestlers that were injured at the hands of the Destruction Crew when they came off the top rope. I mean, they're going to break a young man's neck, somebody's neck.
The Destruction Crew has really been their own worst enemy. They knew the rule. They came off the ropes. You remember a little while ago when they got the award voted by the fans, they threw that away. I mean, they're not popular anymore.
Well, here they go. They try to get the other wrestler into the ring, distract the referee off the top rope. Now watch that.
Oh! Whoa. That's a serious maneuver.
It definitely is. The Destruction Crew has been disqualified. And there you have it, your winners, Kent Carlson and Tom Bennett.
Boy, the crew not happy. I know one guy who's standing by to straighten it all out is Eric Bischoff. He's standing by ringside. Let's hear from Eric now.
Me and Mike Enos, Wayne the Train, Bloom the Destruction Crew. Obviously, playing by the rules just is not on your agenda. However, a rematch with the Trooper and Paul Diamond is on your agenda.
What are you talking about?
Oh my God, the fans voted for it. It's going to happen.
Talking about Diamond and Trooper?
You mean these fans right here?
We already beat the Trooper and Diamond fair and square. And now they're trying to find ways to disqualify us, because there's no other way that they can take these championship belts away from the Destruction Crew.
Well, obviously, you're not very happy about this.
I got a surprise for you.
What's that?
I'm not getting in that ring.
Well, this one.
You know, Diamond, Trooper, all you're asking for.
Wait a minute. I've got a surprise for you. The special ref. Whoa, wait a minute here.
Hey, you guys go up there and call all that crap and play by the rules. You deserve to disqualify.
What do you think you are?
The
messed up pro football player trying to tangle with us wrestlers. If you didn't have them glasses on, we'd kick your stinking head in.
This is nothing about it. Go ahead. We'll talk to you later about the match. Listen, all they're going to do when they go out there, if they go by the rules, guys have been hurt, they lost their careers on what they do out there.
All right, this man, in case you didn't know it, this man, bench warmer Bob Lurcima, former Minnesota Viking, Seattle Seahawks, New York Giant, has been chosen as a special referee by Joe Blanchard for the rematch between the Destruction Crew and Paul Diamond and Trooper. And tell me about it, Bob Lurcima. You're going to take control here.
You have to take control of these guys. You saw what happened right now. I mean, it's out of control. Somebody's got to be a fan's ref. I'm a fan's ref. Have the integrity, see if they can do it the right way and play within the rules. Be awful interesting, but I don't like those guys. They're a couple of jerks as far as I'm concerned. You can put that on tape, too.
All right, well, I'm looking forward to it. I'm sure all you fans are looking forward, and you fans in the television audience, you're going to see it right here on All-Star Wrestling. Stay with us. We're coming back right after this.
This next matchup is scheduled for one fall. Currently in the ring from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, here is Todd Becker. Champion, weighing in at 245
Larry Zbyszko's mouth has not stopped moving since he left the dressing room.
The world what's he hollering about now? Everybody's chanting Larry sucks, and he's just driving him crazy.
He doesn't like it at all. I tell you what, another thing he doesn't like, as we talked about earlier, is the Sarge is right with him now in the Team Challenge Series points.
Well, Sarge said he was coming in. He put a lot of pressure on himself. He's put a lot of pressure on Colonel DeBeers. Pick up points for the team, and they're in a tie for second place with Larry's Legends.
And, you know, we talked about the fact that the Sarge has sort of had a waste of talent, if you will.
I'm walking out of here this time!
And you can hear Zbyszko yelling at the crowd. But Larry's team, on paper, much like the Washington Capitals in the NHL, should be there, but for some reason, never put it together.
Well, it all goes back to, I think, the leadership. You have to turn to your captain, or your coach, or your manager. And in this case, it's Captain Larry Zbyszko.
Well, he's the world champ. What's he doing?
He can't keep the team together.
Okay.
I guess. I mean, he's got the Hangman. He's got the Destruction Crew. Two of the top teams in the world today. He's got Kokina Maximus, 475 pounds. He's got Cowboy Bob Orton, Ivan Koloff. I mean, when you on paper, it looks like the strongest team. But then, you know who's got the most points for his team?
Baron Von Raschke.
No, for Larry Zbyszko.
Oh, for Larry's team? Who? You got me confused.
Jake the Milk,
the guy that he put in order to eliminate him.
The man he's trying to eliminate from his team, a man he's put in matches hoping he would get hurt, has picked up more points for Larry's team than any other member of the team.
And now Zbyszko is going to do battle with Todd Becker.
Did I have you confused?
Yes, you, just for a moment. I'm back at it now,
if I confused you, then I confused the fans. Call in and we'll straighten it out. Call the fan line.
All right. And Zbyszko now looking to confuse young Becker. Zbyszko's tactics usually are to make the opponent wait, especially the younger guys, much like icing a field goal kicker or a free throw shooter. He wants Becker to think about the fact that he's in the ring with the world champion.
Well, you know, when you talk about a field goal kicker kicking under pressure, they don't hear the crowd. There's 70,000 people in the stadium chanting and screaming, and they have to concentrate on kicking that field goal. Larry Zbyszko, the captain of the team right now, is being distracted by the people. And to me, that does not make for a good captain, even a good champion. You shouldn't hear the crowd.
Becker now, however, visibly upset at the fact that he can't get in there and get in and make that first contact. The butterflies churning in young Todd Becker's stomach. Zbyszko being more distracted by what's going on outside the ring as a very vocal crowd here ringside picks it up a notch.
Listen to that music. Larry sucks. Capacity crowd, and they're all on their feet chanting, Larry sucks.
Maybe Zbyszko now will give Becker a chance to have at it. And they lock up at ring center. Zbyszko went right in to the face of Todd Becker. Now not letting him loose. Snapmare down, and oh, here goes Zbyszko to work.
And he turns it on, and there's no stopping Larry Zbyszko once he gets pumped up and on a roll.
Big suplex. Larry quickly up like a cat to get right on his opponent, Becker. Oh, backbreaker. And Zbyszko going for the early pin, but Zbyszko got off. He said, hey, I'm out here. I got big matches coming up.
You know, another thing he was really upset about when he came out to the ring, here comes.
Oh, the Zbyszko pile driver. But just that quickly, he decides to finish it. Count it. You heard him. 1, 2, 3. World champion says, hey, you yell all you want at me. I'm going to do my talking right here.
Well, you know, the fans picked it. They wanted a rematch. Paul Hard Rock Diamond and the Super to meet the Destruction Crew. That's coming up in 2 weeks. A championship match plus a team challenge match. The special referee, Bob Wurtsum, a former NFL football great. And that's what Larry Zbyszko is all hot about.
And I tell you what, Bob Wurtsum, the football player, probably never took a hit as hard as a Zbyszko pile driver. Let's go now to Eric Bischoff.
Thanks, Ralph and Greg, and we're waiting for the heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Zbyszko, fresh out of his match with young Todd Becker. He makes his way to the interview area. Larry Zbyszko, I understand that your travel documents are in order and you're making your way out of the country very soon.
You know, as the heavyweight champion of the world, I'm taken right there. You see it? Larry Land, straight to Tokyo, Japan. And of course, you're just like all the Oriental movies. I saw Shogun. I know the Japanese have seven hearts. First, they want me to wrestle Mr. Saito, who stabbed me right in the back. Then, when I get my game plan, they switch it around, Tatsumi Fujinami, one of Japan's greatest wrestlers, 245 pounds. The man is lean, and he's in shape.
And he's the Japanese champion.
Doing it? I'm doing it for one thing. Because I've been telling you people who the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world is. And I back up. I know I've got a big mouth, Eric. And I love it. Because there's not a soul out here that can shut it. Not in this country, not in Tokyo, Japan, not in...
Well, let me ask you, you're going out a little bit early. I understand you have a special invitation.
Well, you know, ever since I challenged Mike Tyson, the man has maybe seen the light and is showing some respect. All of a sudden, they invite me, Larry Zbyszko, to sit at the Tokyo Dome and watch the Mike Tyson fight. Well, I tell you what, if they think that Mike Tyson and this Holyfield fight is going to be short, wait till they see what I do to Tatsumi Fujinami when I come back to this country and say, hey, Spudhead, what can you say now? Because I am the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world.
Welcome back to All-Star Wrestling. Well, we've got some big stuff going on. Larry Zbyszko he's not happy.
Well, he's not happy about a couple things. First of all, that Bob Lurtzman is the special referee in that team challenge matchup for the tag team title between the Destruction Crew, the Trooper, and Paul Hard Rock Diamond coming up in 2 weeks.
Can Lurtzman be impartial? He said he wasn't going to be, but...
Well, Lurtzman is an athlete. He's a former all-pro football player for the Minnesota Vikings. He played in 2 Super Bowls. He'll be unbiased. He'll do a good job. He'll keep law and order, but he'll be unbiased when it comes to the match time.
And, you know, Zbyszko doesn't have just that on his mind. He is thinking ahead to the Tokyo Dome in Tokyo, Japan, where he's going to wrestle Fujinami for the crown. And, I mean,
well,
that's a big deal, isn't it?
It really is. Well, there's already 62,000 seats sold.
Wow.
And you're still almost a month out before the match. So a lot of interest in that one. Tickets, I understand, average price, $80.
Wow.
Holy
cow.
American money.
Well, and not only interest in that, but interest in the Team Challenge Series abounding here. Later on, we've got the one-armed bandit match, UConn John Nord against this man, Colonel DeBeers.
The year of the 80s saw many a government fall, but South Africa remains strong and will do so throughout the year 2000. But there is but one more coup d'etat to come. And that is going to be when I take away the team from Sergeant Slaughter and start my own army. And then I will no longer have to take orders from him and involve myself in such things as matches with arms tied behind your back. Well, they tell me that this John Nord trains by felling trees with one arm. And then he goes after dinner and wrestles the whole logging camp with just one arm. Well, now, let me tell you something, Lumberjack Nord. You don't have a whole army after you. You got the colonel. And that's all it takes, because I'm going to get the sheik's money once and for all.
Colonel DeBeers is visibly perturbed because he says every time the Sarge has a big match, he takes the colonel to go in and get the points. But, DeBeers brings that on himself.
Well, or a goofy match. It was the turkey hunt.
Yeah.
During Thanksgiving. Slaughter put him in there against Jake Milliman. We saw Jake out here last week with a sign, the colonel's a turkey. I agree with Jake. But DeBeers and Slaughter, there's a lot of dissension. DeBeers better concentrate on the match coming up. Sheik has offered him a ton of money to eliminate UConn John Nord. He's going to have to do it with one arm tied behind his back. I don't think he can do it.
Well, you mentioned dissension in that camp with Colonel DeBeers and Sergeant Slaughter. We heard from DeBeers. Let's now hear from the captain of that team, Sergeant Slaughter.
Before I talk about Colonel DeBeers, I want to let our speaker and the crew know I'm still after them, and I'm not going to forget what they did after that match to me that I beat them on last week. But yes, Colonel DeBeers, I'm picking on you. You said you're a man. You're from South Africa. You can do anything. Well, I got you in a match today. One-armed bandit match. You say you're so tough. You say you're so good. Well, we're going to see how tough you are. I don't like the way you're doing things, and I don't like the idea of my team members taking money from another team member, from the Sheik. I understand, Colonel DeBeers, you have taken money from the Sheik to beat John Nord. Well, I'll tell you one thing. I don't like it.
Sarge, I just want to come out here and apologize to you publicly for what happened to you last week by the hands of my men. But we're going after that top spot in the Team Challenge Series. Maybe it got out of hand, but I just wanted to let you know how we feel about it.
Well, Barrett, I saw the tape. I saw how I won the match, and I have to take your hand and apologize to you. It got a little hot and heavy out there, but I'm sorry what I said to you, but it is a battle. It's for a lot of money, and I hope our friendship can stay after this is all over with.
Well, we'll see. We'll see, but we're going after that top spot just like you are.
Well, we're
going
to beat you.
Well, we're going to try to beat you.
Well, I'll tell you what, Sergeant Slaughter says every time he gets just this close to getting back in the Team Challenge Series, the Colonel is the guy that lets him down.
Slaughter's having a tough time keeping his mind on his team and what they have to accomplish right now. He has dissension with an old friend of his, Baron Von Raschke. Yeah. He's hot after what happened last week with the Russian brute, Knox Baker. They almost did in the Sarge. And now today they got the big one-armed bandit match coming up against Raschke's team. Sarge better concentrate, pull this team together. Get some team unity, or he's not going anywhere, Ralph.
And Baron Von Raschke is going big places. He's in first place, and he's got UConn John Nord today to take on Colonel DeBeers in the one-armed bandit match. Let's hear from UConn John right now about today's upcoming Team Challenge Series main event.
Oh! Colonel DeBeers, it's me and you in a little while in the one-armed bandit match. We tie the one arm behind the back and have at it. Colonel, You know I've been up north in the Yukon. You know I've been up in the camp training. Well, I become king of the lumberjacks up there. And how I used to train, I got my start by this old gentleman named Old Rivers. And he smelled like old whiskey, and he needed a shave. And he told me, he said, Yukon John, there's three types of people in the world. Those who make it happen, those who watch it happen, and those who wonder what the heck happened. Well, Colonel, you're going to wonder what the heck happened. Sheik, you're going to wonder what the heck happened. Bertha, you never failed me yet. You never failed me yet, Bertha. I tell you what, Colonel, you're in for a long, hard match. Oh!
Well, we just heard from UConn John Nord. He will be taking on the Colonel later on in the main event. And coming up right after this, a popular tag team combination. They are on their way.
They really are. In fact, I look for them to be the tag team champions in 1990. And that's the Trooper and Hard Rock Paul Diamond.
They'll be
right
here next. You betcha.
One fall. Introducing the combination currently in the ring. First from Junction City, Kansas, he is Spike Jones. His name is Carter Hill from Atlanta, Georgia. He is W.T. Jones. Their opponents have a combined weight of 533 pounds. Introducing first from Columbia, South Carolina, he is the Trooper. His tag team partner is from the Thunder Bay, Ontario. He is Hard Rock Paul Diamond.
Featuring Hard Rock, Paul Diamond, and the Trooper. These guys, as we mentioned, are now signed for that rematch with the Destruction Crew. That coming up, well, in what?
2 weeks. With Bob Lurtz, the former NFL great, as a special referee. I look for the Trooper and Paul Hard Rock Diamond to take the title from the Destruction Crew.
WT and Spike Jones, we should mention at the outset that they are not related.
The Jones brothers.
The Jones brothers.
I remember both of them, Spike and WT.
Spike has more hair. That's how you tell them apart. That one's Spike, now grappling with Paul Diamond at ring center. Diamond thrown. Spike's a big guy. He's hard to move around.
285 to 290 pounds, like a refrigerator in there.
Diamond, though, very
quick. Oh, beautiful.
Oh, and he got him up and down. Set up high with a flying drop kick. Paul Diamond, very athletic and very mobile.
Well, Paul's a former soccer player. He knows how to use those feet. Let's see how the Trooper and Diamond work as a team together.
Oh, double elbow. Very well, in fact. Trooper in off the tag, right on top, looking for early work of Spike Jones.
He felt he couldn't pin him right there, so he pinned. Oh!
My.
Whoa, a big shot to the big belly of Spike Jones.
working on that arm. Here comes the tag. Those two work very well. Off the second rope, Paul Diamond coming down. The crowd really likes this duo, too, because they're behind them. They can't wait for that match coming up.
Well, you know, they've really been carrying the load for Baron Von Raschke's team, and they've got a lot of points, and the Trooper's still undefeated as a single, and as a team, Diamond and the Trooper are undefeated. You know, talking about team challenge matches, in just a few moments, we've got the big one coming up. Colonel DeBeers off of Sergeant Snipers to meet Yukon John Nord in that one-armed bandit match. One arm tied behind their back. We heard Sheik Adnan LKC offer Colonel DeBeers a ton of money.
Whoa! Very fast. Here is the Trooper. Now tying up WT.
You know, I don't think I've ever seen a man the size of the Trooper, 6'4", 6'5", 285, move as quick. That was a quick, great technique on that arm drag. I mean, he snapped that baby in there.
Now tagging off to his partner, Diamond. The ring has been tipped toward the direction of their corner. Not much work going on. In fact, you can lock down the cameras if we can keep it going the way it's been going. WT now going to work a little bit on Diamond. Back over into the corner. Diamond ducks out of the way. WT is stunned. And Diamond goes to work to try and topple WT Jones. Up, down, tag. Boy, these two really work in concert, don't they?
They really are. I'm really watching them close here. Picking him up. I don't know what he's going for here. I thought he was going for the bear hug. Oh! Reverse.
That one hurt.
Spine cracker.
Oh, my.
Atomic drop, we call that from the behind. Reverse atomic drop, I guess we'd call that. Boy, they're working good as a team, Diamond and the Trooper.
And again, off the second rope, a flying drop kick.
Oh, beautiful. That was gorgeous.
See ya. That's it. One, two, three. Diamond and the Trooper are showing fine form. They are getting it together for that big clash coming up. The World Tag Team Champions, if they see the footage of this match, might have to think a little bit about what's ahead.
We haven't seen these two together a whole lot, but they're working great as a team. Here is the Trooper holding the man up. Diamond coming with that drop kick. Turn out the lights, the party's over.
Well, for more on the upcoming match, let's go now to Eric Bischoff.
The Trooper, you two have got to be ecstatic. Thanks to the fans that voted on the AWA fan line and the AWA Championship Committee, you've got your dream shot. You will face the Destruction Crew in just 2 short weeks.
That's right, Eric. You know, I got to thank all the fans that called in because it meant so much. Without them, we wouldn't have had the shot. So right now, 2 weeks from now, the Trooper and the Hard Rock got to get ready for the biggest battle of their life. But we beat them once, and we know we can do it again.
This is a return match, Trooper. Tell us about it. What's good? How do you see it this time?
I want to first of all say thanks to all the people for calling in and giving us one more shot. And I guarantee you they know as well as we do that we are good enough. We beat them once. We'll do it again. 1, 2, 3, right here in 2 weeks. The new tag team champions.
You know, I understand having a special referee too, Bob Wojtyma. And, you know, I've never needed any help before. But it means a lot when you got a guy that can handle himself and that can handle those two. So there'll be no problems. It'll be 2-on-2. And the Trooper and the Hard Rock will do it.
There's fresh fries and a butthead of the week. Who is it? Call me now.
Hi, I'm Eric Bischoff. And the action is fast and furious here in the AWA. Want to keep up with it all? Call the AWA Fan Line for a review of last week's program and a preview of next week's action.
Hi, I'm Donna. And to find out what kind of lavish lifestyles the Destruction Crew have been living since gaining the World Tag Team titles, give me a call right now.
Some guys can only talk tough, but there are guys that can really back it up. I'm Lee Marshall. You call me now, and I'll tell you about the baddest, roughest, toughest guy ever to put on a pair of tights and get into a professional wrestling ring.
Welcome back to All-Star Wrestling. Well, You saw Paul Hard Rock Diamond and the Trooper, and we will see them against the Destruction Crew that match for the belt in 2 weeks.
2 weeks. Team Challenge Series team match plus a World Tag Team title. Bob Lurtsom and the special referee. Don't miss it.
And we've got the main event here coming up in just a few moments. But first, let's check in with Lee Marshall for an update on the Team Challenge Series standing.
Barron's still leading?
You bet he is.
Thanks, Ralph and Greg. You know, Sergeant Slaughter did his very best last week trying to reignite his Snipers team. The Sarge went into a taped fist match with the Russian Brute, knowing full well the lethal damage that can be done by the Brute's vicious heart punch. The Sarge had another reason to be cautious. Ox Baker. It was Ox Baker that interfered at the end of the match, and it wasn't until team captain Baron Von Raschke came in to save Slaughter that the Ox and his Brute quit their brutal attack. The Sarge was awarded the victory for his team's second straight win. The 2 points pulls the Snipers into a second-place tie with Larry's Legends, but both teams still trail the Blitzers by 5 points. There's still speculation now of a shakeup in the Sniper camp. Tune in next week to see if there are any new developments. Stay tuned for this week's big main event to see if the Snipers can make it 3 in a row and take over sole possession of second place when UConn John faces Colonel DeVere's in a one-arm bandit match later today.
Well, there you have the standings. We'll see if the points change. Well, they'll definitely change in some respect.
Regardless, somehow the outcome of that match.
Who are you picking in the one-arm bandit?
I would pick UConn John Nord simply because he's trained a lot with that.
I have to go with Nord because of that and all the dissension on Sergeant Slaughter's team.
Well, we will find out exactly what will happen as coming up next is the Team Challenge Series main event, the one-arm bandit match. Hang in there. All-Star Wrestling, we are ready to heat it up big-time fashion because the main event Team Challenge Series match is the one-arm bandit match. Nord may have the advantage, but De Beers has a little added incentive.
Well, we'll have to wait and see if Sheik Adnan Al-KC is in the corner of Colonel De Beers. He came out, he offered Colonel De Beers a ton of money, enough money that he said he could retire for the rest of his life if he can put UConn John Nord out of professional
Let's
wrestling.
Let's get right to it right now. Let's go to the ring for the introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following special team challenge event has called for a one-arm bandit challenge match. And the first participant on this event weighs in at 274 pounds. He hails from Johannesburg, South Africa. Here is the South African mercenary, Colonel De Beers. The great Northwoods, here is
UConn
John Nord.
Well, from the Northwoods, it's big. UConn John Nord against Colonel DeVere's in the one-arm bandit match, the Team Challenge Series main event.
And you see the Sheik Adnan Al-KC at the Colonel's side. There's two turkeys for you. Sheik has offered Colonel a ton of money to eliminate UConn John.
Well, let's go up to the ring and find out more about this special match.
Have you heard somebody say, I could beat you with one arm tied behind my back? Well, we're going to find out right now because this is the one-arm bandit match. You've got our two referees, Gary and Scott, and what they are going to do is secure one arm of Colonel DeVere's. They will secure one arm of UConn John, and these guys are going to have to go at each other with one arm tied behind their back. You ready? All right, here we go with the action in the one-arm bandit match.
Well, it's as simple as that, Greg. Just wrap one behind your back, and you got one arm to do battle with. Nord, more used to training like this up in the lumber camps. They worked out like that quite a bit.
They definitely did, and Sheik Adnan Al-KC handed a briefcase to Eric Bischoff at ringside. Full of money. He wants revenge. He wants Colonel De Beers to really do a number on UConn John.
A little dissension in that camp with De Beers and Slaughter.
Oh, there definitely is. I mean, they've been fighting ever since they were on the set when Slaughter found out De Beers was on his team. But De Beers is claiming that every time the going gets tough, Sergeant Slaughter calls on him. Every time there's a different, a unique match.
they call on the Beers, and now they've stuck him in this one-arm bandit match with UConn John.
You know, I've never seen anything like this. I mean, what kind of tactics are you going to have to use, and how is it different for the wrestlers in there? Obviously, balance affected.
Well, their balance will really be affected, Ralph, you know, with one arm behind your back. I don't know. I've never been in a situation like this. I've never had my hand tied behind my back where I had to wrestle. But big UConn John, he's got a little snicker on his face there. He wants a part of the Sheik and Colonel the Beers.
UConn John howling, the crowd, capacity crowd here, going crazy. I can hear them up in the upper decks as well, yelling down at UConn John, howling with him. And Colonel the Beers and he now ready to do battle in a one-arm bandit match.
I think Slaughter is really perturbed that Colonel the Beers would even think of taking money from Sheik Adnan LKC. He said,
Well, it's one of those things.
I swallowed my tongue. Help me.
Okay, it's one of those things, Greg, where, you know, Colonel said, I can start my own team with that kind of money.
I hear they're trying to hit those ropes and come off this. Really good thinking on the Colonel's part, but I wouldn't go against...
Whoa! Holy cow! The Beers wound up with a shoulder block that spun him in there. Well, how's next Wednesday sound, Colonel?
Boy, when he came down on his back with that arm tied behind it, you can imagine the effect that it had on his wrist and shoulder. I know I wouldn't want to be in this match. No way.
Well, it's really tough. You know, do you get a chance to practice this at all? When he found out he was signed, it was a very short time. Before then, he had to come into the ring and actually get it on with UConn John.
I don't know how you would practice. I know how UConn John, he went out and chopped trees with one arm. He said he battled.
And a return from the Bears. Now they're training chops at center.
You can hear those in the top row of the balcony.
Holy cow. Down again went right on the Bears.
Can hear it. I don't think he really realized what he was in for when he stepped in there with UConn John. I mean, this man stands 6'6", weighs 308. The Beer says, no way am I locking wrists or knuckles with you.
Each competitor, as you can notice, favoring their right hand. Both right-handed and up. Gonna need to get a little more than that.
I don't think anybody could pick anybody up.
UConn John doing it, making it look easy.
That was 275 pounds, 6'4", Colonel the Beers going up by one arm by UConn John. Oh, listen to these big forearms.
And the big paw being delivered by UConn John. And rattling him off the ropes, waiting for him.
The Beers trying to move out of the way of that drop kick, but he still caught him in the side of the chest with it, and it knocked the Beers down.
You can see it's harder to even kick out with that one arm. You know, a lot of things affect it.
Man, that's got to hurt back there. Every time you come down on that mat, your wrist, your shoulder.
UConn John with a block and then delivering the head of the Beers. Up to the red padded turnbuckle.
This is definitely in favor of UConn John. I mean, so far it's been all UConn John.
Team challenge series points at stake here, Greg.
Boy, they've got some great, great matchups.
Like a felled oak, you saw the Beers go down.
A big redwood.
Two.
Put on the rope.
Got out of it. Sheik had on LKC looking on from the side.
I don't like the Sheik being at ringside.
Well, a lot of strange things can happen when the Sheik is in the area.
Beers now using a foot and a hand attack. It's about the only way to go. You can't. I don't know how you could put a hold on a man and pull him down unless he got to down underneath and got the foot, got a toe hold.
But it's like, you know, he's going up high on Nord, and it would be like, you know, throwing stones or something at the top of a tree. You got to get it at its base in order to get it to topple.
Well, even then, if you get it to topple, what do you do with it with one?
What a great flying move by UConn John and DeBeers.
Well, UConn John said he had a lot of matches in the lumber camps with one arm tied behind his back, and you can see he looks much more experienced at this technique than does Colonel DeBeers.
Now DeBeers using the head of UConn John to make some impressions here on the mat. Hard block and then return the favor.
Oh, you can hear that head bounce off the mat.
Kicking up high. UConn John
I'll tell you myself, I'm a little claustrophobic, and I think I'd be going crazy in there right now with my hand tied behind my back. Or tied at all. Oh, listen to the chant of the fans. Turkey, turkey. Jake Milliman started that a couple weeks ago. Whoa, a big boot. Oh, and the Bears went right through the second rope. Sheik, hold it. Sheik, what's Sheik doing? Now, we said him. He's definitely untying that.
He's untied.
It's untied. It's untied.
Referee.
Referee can't see what's going on.
Well, UConn John just threw the referee back. He wants Adam.
But it doesn't matter.
Oh, now he's got him. Colonel of the Bears all tied up in the ropes.
One arm, now he's got both arms. Nord coming off the rope. Slicing up over the top. Right to the concrete. Sheik, help it out. Jameer's outside. Bell's ringing.
Both of them hammering on UConn John.
Things are way out of control now, Greg.
This could be the revenge that Sheik Adnan LKC wanted. Nord has still got that one arm tied behind his back, and both Colonel the Bears and Sheik Adnan LKC are hammering on big UConn John.
I hear the bell ring, and Gary DeRuscia can't get in, nor does he want to get between those big bodies. And the Sheik back into the ring.
Gary DeRuscia, the referee, is trying to tie the hand of UConn John. He's got to get loose. He's got to get that hand free, or the Sheik will get his revenge on UConn Nord.
And the only way that the Bears collects is if he delivers the knockout blow.
Well, there he's got the hand free. I don't think he knows where he is. I don't even realize that he's untied.
Either that or he's playing possum, if you will.
Oh, the arm is probably cramped up from being tied behind him.
Yeah.
Somebody's got to get control. We got to get some help out here.
And Nord, though, is regaining consciousness, regaining strength.
Look at that face. Whoa, UConn John.
Oh, they got him mad. They got him mad. Look out, the Bears, Sheik. One, two, big train wreck. Here he goes. That dance we talked about last time, like a wolf prancing after a victory.
Prancing for his prey. UConn John, I'll tell you, I honestly thought that was all over for him. And his arm was tied behind his back. And both Sheik Adnan LKC and UConn and Colonel the Bears were hammering on him. I thought the Sheik was going to get his revenge. I'm very impressed with the durability of UConn John.
And the arm raised high. UConn John is your winner in the Team Challenge Series main event. With the one-arm bandit match victory. Holy cow. That's amazing, Greg.
It definitely is, because I haven't seen anybody with one arm come back after two men were hammering on when Sheik Adnan LKC and Colonel DeBeers were.
All right, well, for more, let's go now to Eric Bischoff.
I don't believe it. Colonel DeBeers hiding under the ring. I want to know what's going to happen with the
money. I've got the money. I beat him. I killed the man.
You got to finish him up in the bottle. One thing up for all, and I promise you that money is all yours. Colonel, don't worry about it. It's your money.
It is my money. Give it here, Sheik.
Don't worry about it.
Wait, man,
not
here. Wait.
Don't be
in
there.
Please, help me out here. Help me out.
Go out of hell, Slaughter. You know what? You're really letting me down. Every time I put you in a situation,
I'm gonna let you down.
You always lose. First, I put you in against Jake the Milkman in a turkey match, and you lose. Now, I put you up against John Nord in a one-arm bandit match, and you lose. And now you take money from this scum, this slime. You know, I've had it with you, and there's something I can do about it. I'm going to do it.
Yeah.
Take a seat. Well, wait a minute.
You can't do anything, Father.
Look out. Wait a minute. Wait.
Hey, hey, hey.
Oh, Colonel the Bears attacking close to Slaughter. Captain of their team.
You're going to get some help down there. You let me down. You let me down. And then Colonel doesn't like it at all. Responding with,
come on, Sarge.
Bashing him. Get up, Sarge. Get up.
Bashing with that briefcase. The Sarge is up.
And then the Bears runs off.
Man, oh, man.
Let's see what, can Eric Bischoff get the Sarge? Eric, get Sergeant Slaughter. Let's go to Eric right now. Eric.
Sergeant Slaughter, I don't know what we're making of this entire situation. Colonel DeBeers is on your team.
If there's anything I can do, Colonel DeBeers, you're finished on my team.
All right. You heard it. You saw it. I don't know what to make of the situation, but stay tuned. We'll try to make some sense out of it very, very soon. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Holy cow! I mean, a complete bombshell. The Sarge says he no longer wants the beers on his team. What can he do?
Put yourself in the Sarge's spot.
Okay.
A guy hits you from behind, a man on your own team.
Yeah.
What would you do?
Well, I guess I'd want him out of there. Now, the next question is, what can he do to get him out of there?
I don't know. This has not come up in the Team Challenge Series bylaws. I haven't heard of anything that Sergeant Slaughter can do.
Well, what he could do is just opt to not put him into the matches. He could
Him in any matches.
But then that raises the question, what is going to happen to that dead spot on the roster? And DeBeers is potentially valuable material.
Well, he definitely, I mean, let's face it, DeBeers is a big gun. He's a heavy hitter, and he can get the job done when he goes in the ring on most occasions. You're right, if Slaughter wouldn't book him in a Team Challenge match, there would be a void there. Who he'd put in there? I don't know. He could come in with a wild card and leave DeBeers sit back. Well, I really don't know. This is
we're going to have to pick this up probably next week as this thing is just going to get unraveled and we'll find out more about it for you. This